And especially if I may bring up the stage list, having three bands and three big stages that Mario doesn't want to be on, compared to other tournaments, like, because usually other, like, a lot of our tournaments I've gone to or seen, like, run rules that were like, no matter what, you're going to go to one of the big stages.
Incineroar! Whoa!
Oh, this is gonna be cool.
That's what I want to see. Oh, all right. Incineroar. It's always cool to see an Incineroar. And you know what? That means Not Braided has to play even more defensive. He can't mash because Revenge is frame three.
Yep.
And, you know, Incineroar, a character who is quite slow. The range is okay, I guess. But, man, does he hit hard. And there's the first Revenge on that fireball.
Yep. Fireballs are no longer a safe, like, long-range neutral option. Because, like, that's just... Oh.
There's two and a big lariat.
It's just not going to work out for you. Oh. MT off to a strong start.
Doesn't make the tech. Oh, unfortunate. Keep going.
I have definitely died at zero to that exact thing. Mario's up B with this stage. So wonky. It drives me nuts.
Just the big damage. Like, not Braided, definitely in kill percent.
Oh!
Wow! Hurtbox shifted the up air?
That was ballsy. Like, just perfectly, like, just being outside that up air's range and then throwing out his own up air. Like,
uh-oh,
at the one frame of work.
Doesn't land the forward air.
Okay.
Oh, man. Yeah, MTE should be glad he did not get hit by that up air.
Oh, that was a side view there. But he was covering the medium roll, probably.
I am noticing a very minimal use of side B there from MTE, which is good. I mean, that's the kind of move you really want to work around when you fight Incineroar, but they're not doing it. It doesn't matter because that forward smash finds a stock.
Yeah, you can't just... That's the thing with, like, not Braided. He loves going for that, and you kind of have to as Mario, because, like, if you're not getting those early cheese combos, you got to rely on, like, just kind of getting those straight smash attacks, because backer, like, doesn't kill until a bit later. And MTE has been, like, definitely, like, been disrespecting Braided and disadvantage a lot. And he's starting to catch on.
He's really getting smothered here by Braided in close range. Almost hits the dunk!
Alright.
Oh, MT really needs to stop a bit of the bleeding here. Forward air, let's see.
I'm surprised he's not going for the down air 2 frame. But I guess it is kind of hard to do against Mario because he has such a big range when he can do it.
And it is a very quick...
Okay. I think he didn't go for the grab because he wants to keep him on stage. Not killing him yet, but Nubbear will kill if he's above the platform.
He still has his jump!
Living. Not Braided. Trying to go for the ledge jump, I think, but going a bit too early on it. And, you know what I think has happened here? I think Not Braided's, like, really trying to bait out the Revenge so he can, like, get some sort of cheap kill off of it. I think that's what's happening.
That back air taking that one. Honestly, this is definitely a possible comeback. The down air doesn't do it. You gotta realize how explosive. Oh, there it is! The back throw.
I don't like that Revenge. You don't want to be, like, going for, like, such, like, committal options when you're at this percent. Especially against a character that can't have trouble killing sometimes.
Oh, no!
Oh, no back air.
An MTE, just still nothing on the board on this last stock, trying to get a dash attack there. Yeah, he's got something. All right. Forward throw. Let's see this edge guard. No flood.
Honestly, Mario doesn't really go for edge guards. He kind of just, like, does that. Yeah.
There you go. You know what? Down air, one of the most reliable Mario moves for killing, and it's one of the most unexpected things, but it's seriously scary.
It's such a scary move, especially if your character doesn't have a good out of shield. Like, it's actually surprisingly safe, because even if you parry it, he can actually just land and just get in our hitbox just like Pikachu's back air.
Exactly. But you know what? I really liked MT's patience. It was just unfortunate that it got to a point where he was at such a high percent that he wasn't really able to properly... to get something started. Like,
yes.
You know, it was constantly in a risk-filled scenario.
Yeah, and
I think, at a lower percent, it wouldn't be too bad.
I think the reason for that is MTE, like, I saw him holding away from Braided a lot, and I wasn't a fan of that, because, honestly, like, I think the main reason MTE lost a lot of stocks was because, like, he just kept getting cornered onto the ledge. And while Mario can't really, like, commit to, like, a burst option, he can definitely, like, stuff you in. Oh, interesting. Sora. Okay.
So there's a third Sora in here?
God damn.
Oh, wow.
All right.
Not what I expected.
The Sora wind counter. Get your records ready. Get your pens ready.
Well, there you go. Not Braided digging in. Getting a good 58% right off the bat.
I can definitely see this being a really annoying matchup for Mario. but we're gonna have to see, like, I want to see how well developed the sword is, because that's gonna be the make or break here.
Ooh, almost saw something cooking, but he dropped the spoon.
Wow!
That okay, jeez. Great positioning on Operator's part.
Wow.
Like, MT went for this, like, elaborate recovery, like, I'm gonna, you know, go this direction, whatever, do this.
My bonk! That's gonna be a big hit, especially, like, especially when you're already, like, down a game, like, you gotta get your momentum.
Exactly.
Especially against Mario, when it's such, like, a battle of attrition.
With only a little bit on the board, these combos, not gonna kill, but you know what? With Mario combos, they kind of work on everyone, even floaty characters, and it's even scarier against floaty characters because they're gonna die earlier.
Brain seems to have a very good idea of when to, like, go for, because MTG's been holding ledge a lot, and, he tried to go for the rare bear. That would have done it. Fano, not Brayden, is, like, fantastic at just, like, knowing when his opponent's gonna not have visibility at the ledge anymore, and he's been abusing it.
Fell out of that downer would have been a certain doom for that stock of MTE. Oh, wow, that barely worked!
Oh,
no!
The air dodge, missing the first hit.
And he's definitely taking his time off stage. That forces a re-grab.
Oh,
wow, great positioning on MTE's part.
Yep. That's the thing about Sora. Like, even if you do get, like, ledge trunks, you can definitely, like, mix up your recovery. You have enough tools to make that work. Or to, like, do something. To, like, throw your opponent off. I like the counters. It keeps Brayden honest. He doesn't want to, like, just keeps him from, like, going from.
Roll behind a back throw. Classic up air doesn't do it. MT cannot buy a stock here in a back air.
Yep. The back air just doesn't come out fast enough.
MTE still can't buy a stock. I remember day one of Sora. I was talking about how strong up B and up air is. Where is it? What is happening?
Where's
the kill power
now?
Where's
the cheese pizza?
No! You cannot kill this Mario.
There it is.
Barely. I swear, all the builder gear that he's got, that's weight.
Sorry, I think you gotta go back to the gummy ship, buddy. I don't think this universe is for you.
Man, cool. There's a lot MT has. Like, if Brayden's gonna live that long on all of his stocks, MT's got a lot to do.
And, you know, the ABB crowd, or the ABB players in the crowd, have been very quiet. And Sora, like, he's fine.
He's going for it again.
Good tech.
Soon as I saw the first one hit, I'm like, he's going for another one.
Sora needs the power of his friends. And his friends are very quiet in the crowd.
That's true. I don't hear nothing.
Where's Goofy and Donald? Without his friends, he can't get anywhere.
True. They inherently nerfed him. Oh, no!
Oh.
I can tell you not Brayden wants.
Yeah,
he wants it. That, if there's anything that all Mario players have in common, is that they want the dunk.
And MTE, like, definitely baiting out Brayden to, like, overextend just a little bit, but, like, not Brayden? So, like, stalwart. He's just not falling for it.
Oh, that's, like, only the second up smash I've seen attempted this set. Barely been using it. That is, like, the Mario, you know?
It's getting to the point where you're taking too much percent to, like, really make your comeback. Oh.
Yeah, especially at this point, like, you take this stock from not Brayden, which he can't, as you can see. Except
okay.
He can. Well, he's at 137%.
There's a chance.
And we can hear the power of friendship going on. Doesn't get hit by that up smash. Let's see this big combo.
Kingdom Hearts is light!
48%? Oh, no! Uh-oh. Still off stage. So scary, no strong back air there. But at 156%, barely hit it with that side B. Oh no!
You know what? Big kudos to MTE, like, just keeping his cool.
Oh no!
Sure, did he want that fire?
I don't know. I wonder if he was going for, like, up B or something.
I was very impressive on MTE's part, bringing it back the way he did, and that's what I was saying earlier on, that it just takes a little bit, and you can make it a mile.
Yeah, and unfortunately, when Sora dies, Mickey Mouse doesn't come to help you in this game.
No.
Not this time. You're on your own, buddy.
Yeah. Well, that's how they nerfed Sora. They took away the friends. He doesn't
have the power. His friendship.
He doesn't have the power of friendship. You go to Hollow Bastion, he goes to Die to the Heart, Goofy and Donald aren't on there. No friends.
I need the pow-pow fruit with Kyrie.